The love that saves, that is Christ, the only Savior of the world. And so, in Christ, the love made person, to be able to win in His name as the Holy and Good Father, merciful and just, that for love of His children, in His infinite mercy, He again gave us His Son in this land of love, descended from heaven on the clouds on June 13, 1947. And soon we are preparing in a few days to celebrate this anniversary. Here is the love of this Father for all His children. And here is the love of children towards this Father, who want to listen and put into practice the teachings of this Son, His Word, in order not to allow the enemy of God to steal this Word. Here is the seed fallen on the road, not to allow the aridity of this world to take the upper hand on everyday life. Here is the seed fallen on the stones and on the rocks, not to allow the troubles and worries of this world to suffocate the Word of God. Here is the seed fallen among the thorns, but to make one's heart in the image and likeness of the most sacred heart of Jesus, and of the Immaculate Heart of Mary, to bring much fruit in abundance, waiting for the final fulfillment that will allow every man and woman of good will to live the kingdom in fullness, that the Father already makes us savor in this land of love. Here is the New Jerusalem. Here is the fulfillment of the scriptures. That little rest of Israel which welcomes, guards and puts into practice the word of Jesus, following the example of she who, found pure and worthy, has received in her faithful heart the Word made flesh, the child Jesus, descended from heaven on a white cloud, teaching everyone, with the Word and with the example of life, to stay on the only way, to proclaim the one truth, to be able to deserve to receive from the Father eternal life, which is Christ. In another house, which was before but now that it is no longer, one is taught to respect all that is in this world, the same as any non-governmental organization, not a church. Respect for the environment, respect for animals, and so on, putting at the center the suffering of migrants, of the poor. All of this is holy, provided that we do not lose sight of the first point from which all this descends and derives. I tell you, all that God the Father Almighty has done, created, must be respected, without if and without but, and special attention must always be given to those who are suffering, to the poor, to those who are victims of war and violence. But once understood and clarified this, to avoid exploitation that must not be, I say again, all the more the reason to respect Christ, the Son of God, the Son of God. And we must respect Mary, the most beautiful work created by God. When this fails in words and deeds, everything else takes second place. The world will be saved definitively when Christ and His Word will be respected and put into practice, teaching everyone to respect it and put it into practice. And to respect Mary, the Mother of God, and not to teach that Mary would have said under the cross lies, "You Father deceived me." If the environment is respected but Christ is trampled on, calling Him the devil, His Word, His teachings, teaching to mix Christ with other religious beliefs that are not an expression of God the Father, and by doing so, by selling off the nature and the divine essence of Christ with all that is humanity, like Buddha, Hinduism, Islam, and so on, one cannot be saved. This is what a Christian must understand and strongly denounce, to give the opportunity to those who want to be saved to be able to be saved, believing and putting into practice the only word that saves, that of Jesus, respecting His teachings, respecting His person, respecting His divinity.